Hello everyone, my name is Atkazi and today we are going to continue our biology chapter of module physics calculation of class 11. This is of course the second part of this lecture series. If you want to see the first part, link will be in the description. Our Discord server link will also be in the description and our website link as well. I will be posting this lecture's personalized MCQs, so you can try them out. So in today's lecture, we are going to see blood groups and division of blood. So let's see blood groups first. So whenever you see blood of two different people, you think that they look pretty similar, right, to the naked eye. It's just a red liquid. But when we go into the microscopic level, there are many different ways in which you can differentiate two different people's blood. So in today's lecture, we are going to see some of those aspects. So let's see grouping of blood first. It is one of them, ABO grouping in Rh antigen. Let's go with ABO grouping first. So whenever you see a RBC, you think of this, right? But in reality, there are many antigens. So there are three types of antigen, A, B and Rh. We are going to learn about Rh later in this video, so we don't have to worry about that. So yeah, ignore this arrow right now. So yeah, there are four different ways, scenarios that can happen in ABO grouping. One is a person can have the A antigen, a person can have the B antigen, or they can have both A and B, and in that scenario we name them AB. And if a person does not have any antigen, A or B, neither A or B nor B, we name them as O. So yeah, the thing about this grouping is people with the A antigen have an antigen against the antibody against the antigen B, and the people with B antigen or RBC have an antibody for the A antigen. So they cannot give blood to each other. So because of this, O, which has none A nor B, neither A nor B, it has both the antibodies A and B, but and the people with both the antigens A, B have no antibodies with them in their body on this ABO. So yeah, so people with O antigen can give blood to everyone, to people A, B and AB, but they but no one can give donate blood to the O people, so that's a problem. And the people with AB can only be donated but and cannot be taken. So yeah, so based on that I made a table. You can take a screenshot of this. So yes, I'm gonna wait for a second. Yeah, let's head on to the next one, Rh grouping. So in this here, Rh means rhesus monkeys. We found this antigen in rhesus monkeys first, so we named it after them. So yeah, this third antigen is the Rh, like I told you. So yeah, in this scenario, there are not like four different ones. We either have the Rh antigen, in that case we give the people the name of positive. If you do not have it, we give it a negative. So it's like AB positive, O negative, O positive, right? So it's like that. So it's easy to pass. So yeah. So the bad thing about this one also is the people who do not have the Rh antigen, who are negative, have antibodies against the antigen Rh antigen. So the positive people cannot give blood to the negative people, but negative people can give the positive people. So that small table we made, A, B, B and O, it has been extended to this pretty big, but yeah. So yeah, that will be the end of this lecture. It was kind of small, but yeah, thank you for attending. I will be making an MCQ. You can try to attempt that so you know that you have learned this lecture properly. And you can also join our Discord server. It is very cool there, many different bots. very friendly community. We have reached 41 members and one level of nitro boosting. Thank you for that, and yeah, see you next week.